North Korea is a really stressful place, and it's a place that you have to take seriously when you visit, because there are consequences for things that you say and the way that you act that don't exist in other countries. On the other hand, if you're completely serious and humorless all the time, I think you just lose your mind. And so I would try as much as possible to bring some levity to our proceedings and to our travels. Met a lot of North Koreans resident in Japan over the years, and they're a very interesting bunch because they're at once North Korean, but also they are not. They're not as foreign as us, but they're also not treated entirely like somebody that has grown up in the DPRK. And once I had a chance to hang out with a young group, one of whom was kind of suspicious of me, didn't really trust me, but nonetheless invited me to do an interview for his Japanese Korean Business Association that he was going to show at their next conference. So stupidly, an hour before our appointment, I thought I would try to squeeze in a bit of a workout. By this time, I developed a personal rule for Pyongyang: exercise every day. Without it, the stress of constant group activity and surveillance could pile up. Many visitors, residents, and indeed North Koreans offset these pressures by drinking, but that creates a downward spiral of productivity and well-being. The other rule I developed was that each trip I take one evening off from the group to watch a movie on my laptop and have some time alone. This time, however, the exercise was a mistake. I didn't leave myself enough time to cool down, so when I showed up to the interview, I was sweating like a drug addict at rehab. I looked, I'm sure, like a panicky wreck. The first few questions were friendly and innocuous, but then the wrestler started dropping inquisitorial bombs. "What do you think of our socialist system?" His annoyed face was back. He was trying to catch me out, to get me in trouble. "Listen," I said, "I think there's a lot of good ideas that are very positive, but there are also some limitations and many things that are inefficient. So I'd like to help improve those things so the country can develop." He then asked, "Which do you like better, North or South Korea?" My God, going for the jugular. Maybe it was better that I was sweating already. Otherwise, I might have started to at this point. "I'm lucky to have been to both," I replied quickly. "And for me, it isn't about which one is better or worse. I like them both in different ways. I want to think of ways that the international community can help the two countries work more closely together and find more in common." He nodded his approval as I wiped my brow again. "That was a good answer," his facial expression said. I added, "The sweeter, crunchier kimchi in the north is better, but the noodles are better in the south. This is why they need to work together." We laughed and good-naturedly argued about whether that was the case. I stand by that controversial claim, despite a popular song called "Pyongyang Cold Noodles Are Best" and the existence of a cold noodle research center in the city, implying Northerners are not resting on their laurels. There's a lot of propaganda about Northern cold noodles. Don't fall for it.